This is the six-beat, six-piece scripture story. This is the overarching rescue plan story. This is part four of the better story. Where is the love Israel longed for from the Lord? 400 years past, it feels like he's on airplane mode. They're home but somehow still exiles. The Romans knocked the door and invited themselves inside. What's the meaning of it all? And what about freedom? How can you know peace when you're ruled by another kingdom? The game-changing moment arrives, meaning the magnificent maker who made everything wrapped in linen cloths, had beauty spots, earlobes and skin, worshipped by shepherds and gifts fit for a king. Jesus grows up, gets baptized by John, the world's sin he erases. John says, "I'm not even fit to tie up his laces." And Jesus faces wilderness, and he overcomes it, preaches Isaiah and says, "I've come to fulfill it," eats meals with the marginalized, dinner with outcasts, healed abseiling paralytics who picked up their own mats. Jesus raised up Lazarus, though he lay in a casket. He fed a stadium full with just one picnic basket. Then to Jerusalem, riding a donkey, passed over palm leaves, Hosanna in harmony, then pass over to Gethsemane, and the blood-soaked prayer sweat to Jesus in handcuffs as he gets arrested. From denial to mock trial to beatings to Pilate, who's swayed by the riots and crucifixion demands, sees perfection but keeps quiet and just washes his hands to the cross. Jesus battered, body teared like flatbread, blood poured out like a cup of red. They erected the Saviour to showcase his suffering. "Forgive them, Lord," he said. "They just don't know what they are doing." With one final cry out, sin's curse is extinguished as love laid out his hands. He said, "It is finished." A spear in his side to double check that he had finished. Is this how it finished? Is this it? Wrapped in burial cloths, they sign the death certificate. This may be the final chapter, but there's a sequel to the story, because on the third day he resurrects to glory, death defeated by the one we call holy. So love surely lives. Yes, the risen one gives a love that no other love compares with. This is the day. This is the day that the game changed, hope reclaimed, victory over death proclaimed as the Messiah's stone was rolled away. The throne of God was on full display because love resurrected on Resurrection Sunday.